वेलकम डॉक्टर अविनाश चंदर टू द स्पेशल एडिशन ऑफ इंटरव्यू फॉर न्यूज़ पोर्टल भारत डिफेंस कवच डॉट कॉम एंड सर इंडिजिनाइजेशन इज़ द मंत्र ऑफ द डे एंड DRDO इज डूइंग एक्सीलेंट जॉब टू मीट दिस नेशनल एस्पिरेशन कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन फॉर दैट
थैंक यू सुशील
वेन वी टॉक ऑफ इंडिजिनाइजेशन आर स्ट्रेटेजिक मिसाइल प्रोग्राम इज टोटली इंडिजिनस एंड वेन वी कंपेयर इट विद अदर नेशंस इंक्लूडिंग आर adversaries. Where do we stand today?
First of all, when you compare the standing, it is a question of what are your threat perceptions, what are your requirements, what are your lethal capabilities you want to create, what is the damaging protection, what is the type of deterrence you want to have. As a policy, we are aiming at the minimum necessary deterrence. To that extent, the capability which has been created and what is planned is meeting the best of the standards as compared to our adversaries.
Best of the standards.
Okay. If you take today, we are making missiles, long range missiles, strategic missiles from 300 kilometers to 5000 kilometers range. On the tactical missiles, we are making surface-to-air missiles, Akash under production. We are also making futuristic missiles in joint partnerships with Israel, LRSAM, MRSAM. We are making an anti-radiation missile development, which we have taken up recently. The aim is to home on to the radiating element for radars and similar stations to make the path of the aircrafts which are falling to make it easier for them to continue and complete their missions. So, these missiles will home on to the radiating devices, and even if they stop radiating, this will still be able to home on to them based on the past information. So, that is the type of weapon from a fairly long distance, good standoff distance, we should be able to destroy the enemy radars.
At what stage is this developing?
This development, we have got already the project is sanctioned, we have got the initial design has been completed, and we will start development soon. Astra air to air missile has gone through very good tests recently.
And so, what about this Agni 5 and Agni 6 or what you call it MIRV? When is the next test of Agni 5 and how many more tests will be conducted before it is inducted into the services, and what's the status of MIRV or Agni 6, whatever you call it?
Any missile which we induct of this class, Agni class of systems, has to go through 4 to 5 tests at least before it gets inducted. Sometimes it may be a little more. So that is what is planned. And second test of Agni 5 should happen within next couple of months.
Okay.
I think we should be able to do by before June.
Before June.
Yeah.
Okay. And what about the MIRV? At what stage this development is program is, sir?
First of all, there is no program like A6.
Okay.
It is a natural extension of A5 and all we are doing. But MIRV is a capability which is a natural derivative of where we have reached.
Okay.
There are many new technologies involved, because if you see Agni 5, it carries about a 1 ton payload stage. When we come to the multiple warheads, the payloads world over come to something like 3 tons.
Oh.
Now, 1 ton to 3 ton payload poses a massive challenge in terms of the design. With the same range. So, you need a much better propulsion systems. So, that is the work which has been initiated. Of course, there are many new technologies for deploying the multiple warheads to create the necessary spread to have futuristic intelligence built into the warheads and the deployment systems. These technologies are being now developed, and I think a good progress is going on.
Any target to test the MIRB capability in near future or in a time to come?
As I told you, we don't have any formal program sanctioned. So right now we are in any program we go through the enabling technologies, create a confidence level, maturity of the progress that's going on. And once the technology is available, and I think the rest is a matter of after that it will take hardly a year, year and a half to be able to launch a missile.
And sir, the space assets are of paramount importance for the economic and strategic interest of the nation. And with the ASAT capabilities with some of our adversaries, particularly China in North, there is always a threat to our space assets. So do we have any program to counter such a threat, or can we also have the capability to incapacitate the adversary to go for such an attack?
You have touched a very vital point actually. If you see today, India has about 22 satellites in space. Out of them, 9 are in geostationary orbits. And they are the heart of India's communication system, television. Any damage on any one of them is going to be psychologically very effective, very important, and more important, and will affect triple the basic communication part. In a today's network centric warfare, there is a very important issue. Now, there are many ways what you can. In fact, if you take the space segment security or the space security as a new emerging discipline or dimension of security, there are many things which we need to do. First of all, we have to track the what are the space situation.
Okay.
We should be able to know whose satellite, which country, what
this
is the origin,
proper data.
What is its intention, is it a threat to us or it's not a threat to us. Identify who are our adversaries, who has destroyed our satellite in case it's destroyed, because mostly it will be destroyed when it is not over our territory. So we should be able to detect and identify. So you need to have a network of sensors on ground and in space which is capable of detecting and identifying each and every object in its space, its maneuvers, its change in path, its course and so on. Basically to catalog and identify the objects. Now, second part is how to deny the use of space. In case your assets are being threatened, there are active denial mode and there is a passive denial mode. There are always, you might have heard of people blinding the satellite when it is crossing your territory. So that is one way of doing. Second is actively hitting it either through laser beams or through the kinetic kill weapons. If you see, we have already demonstrated the ballistic missile kill probability capabilities. Satellite that way is a relatively more benign target for two reasons. One is it has been orbiting for years or months. So, you have all the time to track its path and predict its arrival very accurately. Second is it practically has no maneuvering. Very, very minor maneuvering. It has no defenses. Well, correspondingly, the velocities are higher than a typical missile. So, today, with our launch vehicle capability of ballistic missile launch systems, our missiles are able to reach 1000 kilometers, 2000 kilometers altitude without any problem. That coupled with a kinetic kill vehicle which is used in the anti-ballistic missile defense, you can always generate a capability to kill a satellite. That is not a major issue.
What I understand is that we also have the same capability
as the Chinese, which have been demonstrated by the Chinese
in the past. Then why are we shying away to demonstrate our capability?
I think it is more a matter of the national policy, because if you see, every satellite kill creates huge amount of debris. So we have to take a very conscious decision, because we are playing with the environment, a space which is a pedigree for all the human race. While we need to have the capability, we also have to see a very calibrated and conscious decision when to test it, how to test it. The ability to test anyway is getting demonstrated in the anti-ballistic missile program, so it is not that much of an issue. But let us see, as we evolve and as the threat perceptions change, the policies also change accordingly. But today we are fully capable of creating a weapon of this class at a very short notice.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, and wish you all the best for your future
ventures. Thank you.